हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल फार्मास्यूटिकल कॉन्सेप्ट्स। टुडे वी आर हियर टू लर्न स्पिन स्पिन कपलिंग इन एनएमआर स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी। नाउ व्हाट इज स्पिन स्पिन कपलिंग? इट इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज स्पिन स्पिन स्प्लिटिंग। ईच प्रोटॉन बीइंग अवेयर ऑफ टू स्पिन स्टेट्स ऑफ इट्स नेबर एक्सपीरियंसेस टू इफेक्टिव फील्ड्स फ्रॉम इट and generates two corresponding resonance signals. Now what has been that we have already learnt in my earlier video? I hope you all remember that. If you don't remember, please go back and watch the earlier video. Now the first point here says that each proton being aware of two spin states of its neighbor means what? For example, if I have these two carbons and I have hydrogen, that is nothing but proton on this carbon, and the other substitutions on these carbons, they are different. Suppose it is R dash and it is R double dash. Okay, so that means these both the protons are chemically non-equivalent, so that means they can split each other's signal. Now why? If this is the direction of external magnetic field of magnitude B0, okay, so in presence of this external magnetic field, HB may spin in the direction of external magnetic field or it may spin against the direction of external magnetic field. So these are the two spinning states of HB. And same case can happen with HA also. It can also either spin in the direction of external magnetic field or in the against direction of external magnetic field. Okay, so this particular point is saying each proton being aware of two spin states. Now this HA is aware that HB can spin in two different directions. So now when HB is spinning in the direction, the overall magnetic field felt by the HA, that is effective magnetic field felt by HA, could be different if HB is spinning against the direction. See, this whole molecule we have applied external magnetic field on this whole molecule. Okay, now the neighborhood of this HA, in the neighborhood we have HB. Now if HB is moving in the spinning in the direction, then the magnetic field felt by HA is X, and if HB is spinning against the direction, then the magnetic field felt by HA could be Y. So these are the two effective fields experienced by HA because of two spin states of HB. So here you can take the a very good example of friendship. Suppose you two are friends, okay, and this is you and this is your friend. Okay, now if you are suppose you are going somewhere, you are having fun, and now if your friend is in good mood, the overall atmosphere between you is always good. But if your friend's mood is not good, then the atmosphere felt by you could be different. It is in the same way. It depends on the neighboring proton, the proton which is present on the neighboring carbon. Okay, that decides the peak splitting for one particular proton. So if this is the peak of HA, if this is the say this is the NMR spectrum and this is TMS, if this is the peak of HA, okay, so in that case this peak splits into two because it has one HB adjacent to it. Okay, let us understand more. Therefore the splitting of a signal is due to the different environment of the absorbing proton, not with respect to electrons. This is very important. It is not with respect to electrons, but with respect to nearby protons. Okay, splitting is because of protons present on the adjacent carbon. This is very important. Okay, and if you all remember, I explained you chemical shift, okay, in my earlier video. Now in that chemical shift, for this chemical shift, who is responsible? Those were the circulating electrons which were responsible for chemical shift. Okay, now here for splitting of a signal, okay, in NMR spectrum I am getting one signal for any proton. Now this signal, whether it splits into, whether it is three signals, that is decided by the proton which is present on the adjacent carbon. Magnetically equivalent nuclei do not interact. So this peak splitting occurs based on n plus 1 rule. Means what? As I told you, this HA, okay, see, I am now talking about only peak of HA. I am not talking about peak of HB. Okay, so suppose in this whole NMR spectrum, this is our TMS at 0 delta ppm. Okay, now suppose this is the peak of HA. Now since HA has this neighboring carbon, and on its neighboring carbon it has one proton, it has HB. Okay, so what we have learned, that because HB can spin, or the two possible spinning states of HB makes two effective fields felt by HA, and therefore the signal of HA in the NMR spectrum, I would not see this one peak. I would see this peak splitted into two. Okay, so position of this peak, that is the delta value of the peak, would remain same, but the same peak is just splitting into two. This is called as spin-spin splitting. Now, now let us see what is this n plus 1 rule. If a signal is split by n equivalent protons, it is split into 2ni plus 1, that is n plus 1 for H1. Why? Because what is I? I is spin quantum number. Okay, so this 2n is nothing but the neighboring number of protons present on neighboring carbon, and I is spin quantum number, which is half for 1H. Okay, so that becomes n plus 1. Okay, so this is the n plus 1 rule. That means what? If on adjacent carbon, see here in this particular case, on adjacent carbon we have one proton. So peak of HA, this peak of HA is splitting into n plus 1, that is 1 plus 1 equals to 2. So peak of HA is splitting into 2. Okay. So therefore, if the singlet peak appears, if n plus 0, if 0 plus 1 gives you 1, that means what? If on adjacent carbon there is no proton, on adjacent carbon if there is no proton, suppose you have structure like this, there is carbonyl group over here, there is oxygen over here, and remaining structure on this side. So for this particular hydrogen, on adjacent sides, on adjacent carbon, there is no proton. So peak of this H, peak of this H could be a singlet. It could be a singlet. So there could be doublet. So how does doublet look like? Doublet is like this. Then you can have triplet, quartet, pentet, hextet, heptet. Okay, so these are the peak multiplicities. Okay, Now let us understand relative peak intensities of symmetric multiplets. Okay. Now, as I told you, singlet. So singlet looks like this. It's a single peak. Okay. This, how much should be the intensity in case of doublet? See, when I said the peak is splitted into two, so this doublet is looking like this. Why not like this? Why not like this? Why doublet is not looking like this? Why it is like this? Why I have drawn same intensity for both the peaks in that particular multiplet? Okay, multiplet means what? Whatever is not singlet, that is called as multiplet. Means doublet, triplet, quartet, pentet, hextet, heptet, these all are multiplets. Okay, and these small peaks of each multiplet, okay, these are the peaks of each multiplet. Now if you see, when I draw this doublet, I am drawing intensity of each peak same. Okay, why this? This depends on the Pascal's triangle. Now what is Pascal's triangle? See here, one on either side, below I am writing one, again on either sides I am writing one. Okay, now 1 plus 1 is 2. Again, next line on either sides I am writing 1. 1 plus 2 is 3. 2 plus 1 is 3. Again on either sides 1. 3 plus 1 4. 3 plus 3 6. 3 plus 1 4. Again on either sides 1. 4 plus 1 5. 6 plus 4 10. This is also 10, this is also 5. Either side 1, this is 6, this is 15, this is 20, again this is 15, this is 6. Okay, so in this way, this is first is singlet when the proton doesn't have on the adjacent carbons, proton is not present. Okay, this is doublet, triplet, quartet, pentet, hextet and heptet. Okay, so I have shown you how this singlet looks like, doublet. So this is the triplet. If you see, this is 1 is to 2 is to 1. Let me draw it correctly again. Okay, so this is 1 is to 2 is to 1, that is the intensity, okay, given by Pascal's triangle. Okay, so therefore the middle peak, this middle peak I have drawn quite heighted as compared to the peaks on adjacent sides. Okay, now here I can draw it like this, that is quartet. Then I can draw like this, that is pentet. We can draw heptet also like this. Okay, hextet we will try. Okay, so these two peaks would be of similar intensity in this case. So these are the relative peak intensities of symmetric multiplets. Now these are some of the rules of spin-spin splitting we are learning. The first rule is equivalent protons do not split each other. So for example, if I give you this example, suppose there is one electronegative atom like chlorine, and on this carbon I have these three hydrogens. Now see, all the three hydrogens, they are present on same carbon. They are present on same carbon, and this carbon has only this chlorine adjacent to it. So all these protons are chemically equivalent. Okay, they are chemically equivalent, and thus no splitting would occur. Okay, these three would not split each other. okay, we will get, since these are chemically equivalent, for these three hydrogens we will get a same peak, so we can call it as HA. Okay, all these three hydrogens, they will give a singlet, because they do not have any hydrogen on the adjacent carbon. Let us take one more example. Again, say this chlorine is on adjacent sides, on adjacent carbons, and these hydrogens. Okay, so in this case, if you see, these two carbons are present on one carbon, these two hydrogens are present on one carbon, these two hydrogens are present on one carbon, and these both the carbons, they have chlorine on them. So we can say that these four hydrogens, again, they are chemically equivalent. So these four hydrogens, they would give a same peak, and that would be singlet. Okay, are you getting the difference? See, in this case, these four carbons are placed on two different, these four hydrogens are present on two different carbons. Two here, two here. Still, they are not splitting each other. Why? Because all four of them are chemically equivalent. Second rule. Protons that are farther than two carbon atoms apart do not split each other. Now let us see this example. Suppose these are the protons I'm talking about, and the substitutions on these carbons are different. Okay, this is the same example which I shown you on the earlier slide. So now in this case, this one hydrogen and this one hydrogen, they are chemically non-equivalent. So in that case, they both would split each other. Now, what is on adjacent carbon of HA? One hydrogen. Okay, that means peak of HA would split into two. So, it would be a doublet. What about HB? HB also has one hydrogen on the adjacent carbon. So, peak of HB will also split into two, which is called as doublet. So this is based on N plus 1 rule. Now let us take one more example. CCC. Suppose all these are bonds and there is hydrogen over here. Okay. Now these, in this case, splitting will not be observed. Why? Because they are far from each other. Okay, protons that are farther than two carbons atom apart do not split each other. So, in that case, splitting would not occur. Suppose here also there is no proton, here also there is no proton. So, in that case, this will give a singlet and this will also give a singlet. Okay, now let us see how does this happen. Splitting. So in this case, we have already seen that the if I am drawing peak of HA. Okay, so this peak of HA splits into two. So that is a doublet. Okay, and the peak intensity is 1:1. This is why this happened, because it has HB on adjacent side. Why peak of H is splitted? Because it has HB on adjacent side. Okay, this is HB, this is HA, R double dash. Okay, this is to understand that they have a different neighborhood and they are chemically non-equivalent. Okay, so this HB can either spin in the direction or against the direction, and therefore the peak of H is splitted into two. Now, in case on the adjacent carbon of HA, there are two protons. Okay, that means now HA has two hydrogens on the neighboring carbon. Okay, so what will happen with the peak of HA?
So on adjacent carbon, okay, there are two hydrogens and these both are chemical equivalent. So I have written HB and HB. Okay, so HB, HB, they are not splitting each other. HB is splitting HA. Okay, so these both the HBs now will affect HA. Why? Because it may happen that they both are spinning in the direction of external magnetic field. It may happen that both the HBs are spinning against the direction of external magnetic field. Or it may happen that among these two, one is spinning in the direction, one is spinning against the direction. Okay. Or this one is spinning against the direction and this one is spinning in the direction. So this I will write over here. Okay. So since there are two hydrogens on adjacent carbon, the peak of HA will split into 3. In 1 is to 2 is to 1 pattern. So this would be a triplet. We call it as triplet. Hope this is clear. And a last example, if this HA has 3 protons on adjacent carbon. Okay, so in that case, what would happen? See, all these three, I have written same alphabet, no? Means what? They three are chemical equivalent. So, they are not splitting each other. But, what they have on the adjacent carbon? They have this HA on adjacent carbon. So, they will split HA signal. So, now how will be the H signal of HA? HA signal is splitting because of these three hydrogens on the adjacent carbon. So based on n plus 1 rule, this 3 plus 1 becomes 4. So it will split into 4. Okay, and as per Pascal's triangle, that would be 1 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1. This is the intensity, peak intensity of the multiplet. Okay, now ye kaise aayega abhi? 1 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1. It may happen that all the three are spinning in the direction or all the three are spinning against the direction, right? Or it may happen that two of them are spinning in the direction, one is spinning against the direction. Okay, now in this case, which two are spinning in the direction, that is also important. Suppose these two are spinning in the direction and the middle one is against the direction. Or it may happen that the first two are spinning in the direction and the last one against the direction. Okay. Now in this case, where two are spinning against the direction, it may happen that these two are spinning against the direction and the center one is in the okay. So in this way, the peak splitting of HA would occur and we will get a quartet for HA. So this was the direction of external magnetic field I was talking about, and all these small arrows, they are showing the direction of spin for HB in three different cases. Now here you remember we have seen the peak splitting of only HA. Okay, so what will happen with HB here? HB's peak, what will happen with the peak of HB? That we have not seen here. What is there on the adjacent carbon of HB? It is only HA, only one hydrogen. So peak of HB would split into 1 plus 1, that is doublet. Now what is coupling constant? It is a distance between the peaks of multiplet. Means what? Multiplet means what? Multiplet means doublet, multiplet means triplet, multiplet means quartet. Okay, so this distance between the peaks of multiplet, this distance is called as coupling constant. It is denoted by J and it is measured in hertz. It is not dependent on strength of the external field. Multiplets with the same coupling constants may come from adjacent groups of protons that split each other. It's a quantitative amount by which peaks were split, and it's a measure of how strongly a nucleus is affected by the spin state of its neighbor. Means what? Larger the value of J, stronger is the coupling. Okay, so what is J? What is coupling constant? It is extent of coupling. Extent, how extensive is your friendship with your friend X and with your friend Y? Suppose you have two friends. You have, this is you, and you have this one friend, you have this another friend. So your extent of friendship with this friend and with this friend could be different. Okay, so that extent of coupling is called as coupling constant. Okay, because they both are in your neighborhood and they have come from different environment, means they both are in different environment, different chemical environment. Okay, so your coupling with both of them would be different, and that, how much is that? That is, its magnitude is shown by coupling constant. Its magnitude is called as coupling constant, which is measured in hertz. Okay, so its last point is important. It's a measure of how strongly a nucleus is affected by the spin state of its neighbor. So some of the applications over here. So if you see here in this particular example, the J value is 7 hertz, okay, where the free rotation is possible because there are no double bonds. So hydrogen atoms on CH2 of alkene, in this case this is alkene, okay, so hydrogen atoms on CH2 of this alkene do not have to be equivalent. These, if you see these two, they can or cannot be equivalent. It is depending on the substitution which is present over here, and as a result they both can couple with each other. Okay, so this is called as two bond coupling. This is, if you see, cis transformation, cis orientation, transposition and geminal positions, and according to their positions these J values are also different. Okay, so J value, that is coupling constant value, helps us to predict the position of these hydrogens. Now J value also helps us in predicting the ortho, meta and allylic positions of the hydrogens. Now some important points, like coupling between hydrogens which are more than 3 bonds, that is also possible sometimes, and that is called as long range coupling. And in general, the more bonds involved between hydrogen that are coupling, the smaller will be the J value. And long range coupling is more common with rigid systems like benzene. Okay, there the long range coupling would be common. Let us learn more about inverted tree diagram. So this is nothing but the another way of writing or another way of representing peak multiplicities or peak splittings. So this is, first is AX system. Suppose you have this system HA and HX into it. HA and HX are in different chemical environment. Means both are chemically and magnetically non-equivalent, thus they couple with each other and split each other's signal. So let us see peak of this HA. So suppose this is the peak of HA, which is splitting because of HX. So peak of HA splits because of presence of HX on adjacent carbon using rule N plus 1. So this is 1:1 splitting, and this is the coupling constant between HA and HX, and we call this peak as doublet. Now let us say HX, peak of HX, this is the peak of HX, it is splitting because of presence of HA on adjacent carbon based on rule N plus 1. Okay, and again the splitting is 1:1, and the distance between the peaks of multiplet is JXA, and this is also a doublet. Now here what you have to remember, as both the protons couple each other, their coupling constants would be same. JAX is equal to JXA. This is very important. See the another system, AX2. Okay. So, this is A and X2. Okay. The alphabet, as alphabet changes, the chemical environment is changed. And number denotes the number of protons present in that particular environment. Okay, so let us see first, HA and HXs are in different chemical environment, means protons in both the sets are chemically and magnetically non-equivalent. Since HX1 and HX2 are in same chemical environment, extent to which HA couples with HX1 and HX2 is same. So this is the peak of HX1 and HX2. See that this you have already understood. Since these two are in same chemical environment, they both will give a single peak. Okay? They both will give a single peak. Now what is the multiplicity of that peak? That depends on the proton present on the adjacent carbon. Okay? So HA is present on adjacent carbon, and because of HA, the peak is splitting into two. And the coupling constant is JXA. The peak is a doublet, that is 1:1. Now let us see peak of HA. So this is the peak of HA. It will first split because of HX1. And then it will further split because of HX2. Okay. So if you have seen here, this is one line. And now this is drawn twice over here. So it is 1:2, 2:1 triplet. And since HX1 and HX2 are in same chemical environment, they are in same chemical environment, the extent to which HA couples with both of them, extent to which HA couples with both of them is same. And therefore, the coupling constant JX1, JX2, JX2, these all are same. So, JX1 equals to JX2 and JXA. Next system is AX3. So, AX3 means there are two types of protons. See, 1 and 2. Two types of protons are present, and in the second type, there are three chemically equivalent protons. So, HA and HXS are in different chemical environment. Means protons in both the sets are chemically and magnetically non-equivalent. HX1 and HX2 are in same chemical environment, and extent to which HA couples with HX1, HX2 and HX3 will be same. Now let us see peak of HA is first splitting because of HX1, then this is the coupling constant, then next the peak would split because of HX2. See here, this is drawn once and then this is drawn twice. Okay, now further HA is coupling with HX3, so this is first splitting, and now here see these two lines are further coming down over here. two lines. This one line is already there, and now these two lines will be here. Okay. So this becomes 3. Now here, see, these two lines have come here also. So these two lines, and now this splitting will bring one more line. So 3 lines will come over here. Okay. And all these coupling constants are same. So this is 1:3:3:1 quartet for AX3 system. And what about the peak of HX1, HX2, HX3? See, these three are, all the three are in same chemical environment. So all these three hydrogens are giving a single peak. Now what is the multiplicity of that peak? That depends on the adjacent HA. So on adjacent carbon they have only one proton, so it is 1+1 splitting into 2, so that is 1:1. Okay, and in the whole case all the coupling constants are same, all these coupling constants are same. Next system is AMX system. Okay, so now you can observe 3 different alphabets, that means 3 different sets of protons are there. So this is HA, M and X. You can see the substitution on either side is different. So all the 3 protons are in different chemical environment. Okay, so let us see first peak of HA. It will split first because of HX, and then this is JAX is the coupling constant. Now as I told you earlier also, these are 3 friends, okay, HA, HM and HX, but extent of friendship with this one and with this one is different because they both are in different chemical environment. Okay, so now this JAX would not be same as the JAM. Let us see, peak of HA has split because of HX, now it will further split because of HM. So it will further split into 2 and 2. Okay, so you can see this distance is smaller as compared to this distance. So this difference in distance between the peaks of multiplet, I have shown just to tell you that the extent of coupling of HA with HX and with HM is different. So this is JAM, and now this JAM is not equal to JAX. Let us see further. It may happen, you may say that why HA is first coupling with HX, why it is not first coupling with HM and then with HX. So that is also shown here. HA may split because of HM into 2. Okay, you can see the distance I have kept same. Okay, this JAM, and then it will further split because of HX. Okay, so distance again between the peaks I have kept same. So now this is 1:1:1. This is also 1:1:1:1, and this is not quartet, because if it is quartet, we should follow these intensities. Okay, so this is not quartet. These all are equal intensities of the multiplet. So we call it as doublet of doublet.
Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe the channel and leave your comments. Bye, have a nice day.